I think this is a pretty tricky limit question from the AP Calc BC test in the year of 2016. Such a long time ago, right? Especially for the people who just started your AP Calc class, when you take the AP test next year, that's exactly 10 years ago. But anyways though, the OP is asking, can you explain why we approach from the left side rather than the right side? And the correct answer is 3. Why not 4? Why not DNE? Let's take a look. First though, we have the graph for f of x. The question is asking the limit as x approaching 0 of f of 1 minus x squared. Don't do this. Don't just plug in 0 into here and say that's f of 1 minus 0 squared. And that's of course 0, 1 minus 0 is still 1. F of 1. 1 is right here, and this is the graph for f of x. So plugging 1, if you look at the y value, we get the f of 1, right? So it looks like the answer is equal to 2. No, it's not this. The answer is not 2. Because remember, when we are taking limit, x is not exactly 0. And be really careful with this though. When we have x approaching 0, there's no plus or minus here. What do we have to do? We have to do both directions. So for this one right here, we first have to check the limit as x approaching 0. Let's do it from the left hand side. So 0 is a minus of this right here first. And I'm just going to abuse the notation a little bit. So I technically had to plug in 0 minus into here. So I will be getting f of 1 minus 0 minus and then squared like this. Now, what exactly is 0 minus? You can just think about 0 minus as just think about this as a number that's a little bit less than 0. Well, in this case, it would be negative 0.0001. That's a little bit less than 0. So in this case, when you square this right here, you get what? You get a positive number that's a little bit bigger than 0. So this is going to be approaching. I'm using the arrow for approaching. F of 1 is still 1, minus is still minus. 0 minus square becomes 0 plus. Again, just imagine that you have to square this, right? It becomes a positive number, but it's still very, very small. So this becomes 0 plus. That's how we get that. Now, what is 1 minus 0 plus though? Well, 0 plus, just think about this as a number that's a little bit bigger than 0. So that's 0.0001. If you have 1 minus 0, again, this is technically a number that's a little bit bigger than 0. Just think about this as 1 minus 0.0001. It's at 0.99999. This is going to be f of 1 minus, meaning a number a little bit less than 1. This is 0.0.999999. So now, if you look at this, f of 1 minus, what you have to do is, we are approaching 1 from the left-hand side. Again, right here, even though this graph, it's not the same as that, but I'm really looking at f of 1 minus. If we approach 1 from the left-hand side, you can see the graph, it's approaching 3. So it's like this. The y value is approaching 3. So the answer for this part is equal to 3. Now, we will also have to check the limit as x approaching 0 from the positive direction. And this is still the same function. Now, do the same thing. We plug in 0 plus into this x. So that's f of 1 minus 0 plus squared. We are going to do pretty much the same thing. 0 plus squared. Guess what? That is still going to be 0 plus. Still positive, a little bit bigger than 0. So we get f of 1 minus still 0 plus. 1 minus 0 plus, same story right here. This is approaching 1 minus. It's a little bit less than 1. We are still looking at the limit as x approaching 1 from the left hand side, so it's still going to be like this. Still equal to 3. Now, as we can see, this is equal to that. When the left limit and also the right limit are equal, we can come here and say the answer for this right here is that number. That's why this right here is equal to 3. Not 4, because in fact, of the square, we never get to the other side because of this right here. So that's it. Hopefully this right here helps.